So today we're going to be breaking down a jazzy bossa nova beat inside of FL Studio. First thing for the beat, unlike all of my other melodies, I started off with the drums, which is super unusual for me. So I started off by laying out this pattern and then building it off from there. After that, I added a clef. Then a triangle, a ride, and a shaker. And then finally, an acoustic bass for the bass line. After I had that drum pattern figured out, it was a lot easier to figure out the rhythm that the chords need to be chopped in. So I started off by grabbing the classic nylon guitar for the chords, then I layered that with the Double Felt Grand Clear preset from Omnisphere, and here's what those sound like once they're stacked together. So then looking at the MIDI for both the guitar and the piano, they use the exact same MIDI of these chopped 7th and 9th chords. So just as a quick reminder, for those 7th and 9th chords, you're going to want to start off by grabbing your triad, then grab your 7th, and then your 9th. For this melody to get that descending feel, I also switched out the C sharp for a C, which technically isn't in the scale of D sharp minor, but it still worked really well in getting a descending feel and again keeping that jazzy feel to the chord progression. Another chord that uses that same kind of principle of using a note that's not in the scale is this one here. And again, that A actually isn't in the scale of D sharp minor, but it works really well. Particularly, I like to use this one for more like plug and B and new jazz type melodies, but that's just another example of, you know, something that has a note in the chord that isn't in the scale. So then hopping back to that original MIDI, as you can see, here are those two chords that we just broke down. So we have the triad, we have the 7th, and then we have the 9th, and then here's the chord that uses the C that's not in the scale. After I had those two chords figured out, I pretty much just transposed them down to the next root note in the scale, and then transposed it a little bit to get it to fit. So I went ahead and put this chord down two, so it gets to C sharp, and then I went ahead and put this E up one for the F. Now you can see those two chords match, and again we're keeping that jazzy ninth chord feeling just all the way through the progression. And then moving on to the MIDI for the guitar top line, again it's super simple, but this is one of those things where I just kind of clicked it in listening to the chords over and over again just to get it to sound right. So then as you guys saw, I went ahead and rendered all three of those patterns out, but I added some effects before I did. So I started off with this Time Machine plugin with the mix turned down to about 5%, then a Fruity Fast Distort again with the mix turned down to about 5%, then a delay on the Saturated preset again with the mix turned down to about 10% on this one, then an EQ just to filter it out with the mix turned down to about 40%, then of course an EQ just to cut the lows, and then finally a Fruity compressor on the Vintage preset. After that, the last thing I did to the chords was went ahead and pitched them down an octave just to get a little bit of a deeper and kind of more sampled sound to the melody. Next up in the melody after those chords, I went ahead and added a Rhodes and a pad to kind of fill up the background of the melody. So for the pad, I grabbed the Juno 60 Dark Pad Slow, and again this is one of those sound source files within Omnisphere. Then I grabbed the Rhodes LA Custom Chorus from Keyscape, so here's what those sound like once they're combined together. So then hopping over and looking at the MIDI for both of those sounds, they just went ahead and copied those exact same chords that we broke down just a second ago, but I went ahead and removed all of the chops, so it's a little less complex and it can just kind of sit in the background and fill up a lot of space. Really the interesting thing with this pattern is the effects I used on the pad to get it to sound really nice. So I started off with a Fruity Reverb 2 with the mix turned all the way up, then Fracture on the Classic Beat Repeater preset to give it a little bit of texture, then Portal on the Pitch Artifacts preset, then Fruity Chorus with the mix turned down to 50%, then of course an EQ just to cut the lows, and then finally an Imager just to get that pad sounding really big and wide. After that pad and Rhodes were all sounding nice, I went ahead and added three sounds together that kind of form a top line. So the first one is a lead from Serum called B, then a brass one shot, and then finally a sine bell. So here's what those sound like once they're all stacked together. Starting off with the MIDI for the B bleed, really the goal for this was just to kind of accent that clav pattern that was in the drum pattern. I really liked the way that sounded and it added a lot of bounce to the melody, so I kind of wanted to accentuate that with a more melodic pattern as well, so here's what that ended up looking like. Going along with that, the sine bell does the exact same thing and just copies that sort of clav pattern. Then finally, the MIDI for that brass is the most complex out of the three, but yet again, this is kind of something that I just clicked in by ear when I was listening to the chords over and over and over again. Really, the only important thing to mention here is that I made the one-shot slide, and how you do that is just by going into the sampler, of course, and then you want to click over to the wrench icon, then go over to the polyphony section and switch the max to 1, turn on porta and mono, and then put the slide factor to about 0.06. So then moving on to the effects for those three sounds, I went ahead and kept the B bleed as dry as possible, so I didn't put any effects on it. But then for the sine bell, like I mentioned before, I put a lot of instances of Portal on it. So I started off with the crystalline accent preset from Portal, and then I also added the sandbox preset from Portal. Then for the last effect on that sine bell, I went ahead and added Valhalla Supermassive on the skinny eighth preset with the mix turned down to about 50%. Then moving on to that brass lead, I started off by again putting Portal on it, but this time on the tweak ramp preset, and the mix on this is about at 75%. Then I added Fruity Love Filter on the sequenced gate preset, and then finally, of course, an EQ just to cut the lows. So then for the final three sounds in the beat, I went ahead and combined three to make a really interesting bass line. So for the first sound, I grabbed the Honky Tonk Piano from Keyscape, then I grabbed an acoustic bass one shot, and then finally the clipped Signs bass from Omnisphere. So here's what those sound like once they're all stacked together. So then moving on to the MIDI for the Honky Tonk Piano, really it's pretty simple and it just uses the root notes of the chords at a bunch of different octaves. So all I did was copy the root notes of the chords, so as you can see, D sharp, C sharp, D sharp, and then A sharp, and then I just went ahead and split that up into three octaves and then also chopped it up to kind of get a nice little rhythm to the pattern. Really the only important thing to mention with that sound is that I actually ended up cutting all of the lows so it doesn't get too muddy. So that being said, here's the MIDI for that sub bass, and of course it's very simple, and I just have it playing two notes, and they're of course the root notes for the chords. Then finally the MIDI for the acoustic bass, and like a lot of the times when I use both a sub bass and an acoustic bass, I just have them switch on and off. So as you just saw in that other pattern, the sub bass is just playing here and here, so then I have this little roll and then it completely switches to the acoustic bass. So again, they kind of swap back and forth. I do it in a ton of my melodies and it always just works really well. So starting off with the effects for the Honky Tonk Piano, first up I grabbed an EQ just to boost the low mids and cut out some of the highs, and then I grabbed another EQ and like I mentioned, I just went ahead and cut all the lows so there was room for the sub bass. Then for the acoustic bass, I just went ahead and kept that dry, and then for the sub bass, I started off by adding Portal on the low fuzz preset with the mix turned down to about 5%. And then finally, I went ahead and added this EQ to boost the lows and cut out of the highs on that sub bass. After the effects were put on that bass line, the melody and the beat were pretty much complete, so here's what everything sounds like once it's all combined. Again, that's going to be pretty much it for the video. I like the way this turned out. It's my first time making jazzy bossa nova, I guess. But yeah, fully expect that the rap beat tutorials are going to go out the window, because it's way more fun making like bedroom pop and like jazzy stuff. So yeah, a little heads up, probably not going to do as many of those. There still are a bunch that are scheduled that I have had filmed for months, so. But yeah, a lot more fun making these than that. But yeah, really tired. Somehow hurt my elbow. That's it. Yeah, bye. Thanks for watching.